on the path of knowledge, we can identify the root of all ignorance. This we can call as the fundamental ignorance, because of which all other beliefs, all other assumptions and delusions, they crop up in the mind of the ignorant person. And the most fundamental of the ignorances is not knowing my own true nature and not knowing the true nature of our own experience, which is this world in the body, in the mind. And as a result, assuming that whatever I perceive is true, is most real, and I am, as this body, is a separate individual, and I am very limited. I was born and I am going to die. Better do everything by all means possible in this short period. Which means this person needs to survive, do nothing else but survive, and fulfill as many desires as possible. Be a slave of the desires that pop up in the mind. And the fundamental ignorance leads to a state of the mind which is called suffering. So what are we trying to do here on the path of knowledge is removing these beliefs from our minds through the valid means of knowledge and through the criteria for truth that are absolutely strict. This gets rid of the ignorance and all the consequences of ignorance that we listed in the last episode. This can be done by gaining knowledge. As you already know, the knowledge is a product of our experience. And as you know from the earlier episodes, that all the experience falls in the category of the false. All the experience is illusory. So that makes all the knowledge false. This is a strange situation. Because a seeker on the path of knowledge is expecting knowledge, is expecting truth, and given the means of knowledge as his own experience, he is expecting that I will know the truth. But the knowledge that is gained out of this false experience, this illusory experience, is not really knowledge. So I have taken a full 180 degree turn here, changed my tune completely. And now you must be wondering, well, so much for the path of knowledge. I thought that this path is going to give me truth. This path is going to give me knowledge. But with this conclusion, it looks like it was a complete failure after all. So, if we do not gain any knowledge, what do we really gain here? The knowledge is simply an arrangement of experience in the memory, as you know, and has no truth in it. This arrangement itself is false. This arrangement itself is interrelations among names and forms, which are illusory. There is no use of this knowledge. So why get it? Why take all this trouble? I'm not going to keep you confused for long. As you know, there is nothing to know. In this emptiness, which is the existence itself, which is this experiencer itself, there is hardly anything to know. And therefore, whatever is known is false all the time. What has happened is we have accumulated a lot of ignorance, which we call as knowledge. Whatever we think is knowledge is actually masquerading as knowledge. It is just ignorance. And as we saw in the last episode and from the concept of the fundamental ignorance, our job is now to reduce this ignorance. Our job is now to remove all that which was accumulated in the name of knowledge. So as we experience and we apply logic to the experience, we start destroying these arrangements of experiences in the mind, which cropped up because of our wrong understanding and inability to know anything, because of our ignorance. Whatever I said can be very confusing. So let us take a metaphor. You are lost in a desert. Now all you want is water. You're very thirsty, about to die. And on the horizon, you see a shiny streak of light reflecting sunlight. And you say, finally, water. It is my direct experience. And this water will save me. Now you run towards the water. Your knowledge tells you that the water is about 10 kilometers away and you need to go in that direction. And as you run to it, you see that it is always 10 kilometers away. It does not look like that it is coming closer. You summon your logical abilities. And now you can see your new experience in this light of old experience. That no matter how much I travel, I never reach the water. And logic tells me that it is impossible. So probably it's not water. Still, you don't believe your own mind. You run and you find the same thing repeats. That shimmering water is always far away. It's always on the horizon. You take out your telescope and you check it finally. You see the same thing, but it's far away. It does not show you anything except this shiny illusion. There are no trees, there are no people, there are no animals. And now you conclude that whatever I assumed is wrong. And this you know through the new experience that you gained and through the instruments that you used for experimentation and through application of the logic. So the water turned into mirage. Did you gain any knowledge about the water? No. Only thing was that the belief that it is water was dropped. It was dropped by getting new experience, by utilizing the logical abilities of the mind, by concluding rationally. And probably that will save your life, because if you keep running after the mirage, well, there was no hope. So it looks like that I'm gaining something on the path of knowledge. What is really happening is I'm losing ignorance. I'm losing all that which was assumed and accumulated was false. The truth is seen as uncovering of that which was false. That's all. So as we gain knowledge, even if it is coming from the experience which is itself is not true, we start destroying the ignorance. Although gaining nothing in absolute terms, knowledge is simply refinement of ignorance. Nothing is gained. You will never know anything. What will happen is whatever you know and think is my knowledge will be reduced, will be dropped, will be cleaned up. Knowing on the path of knowledge is a process of reduction, purification, subtraction, cleaning, dropping, removing. So a distinction must be made in the common meaning of knowing. For example, you learn a skill, you learn a job, you learn a new language. Here you are gaining something. And learning is via experience. So you gain more and more experience of something and then is impressed on the mind. This arrangement of experience is formed in the mind. Now you can use it for something, to take an action. Usually it is for survival or entertainment or anything. It is not for removal of ignorance. But here, as we gain knowledge, we lose something. Every day we lose something. So by now, you must have lost a lot of beliefs. If you heard all the preceding episodes and if you introspected on them, if you pondered on them with an open mind, a skeptical and critical mind. So you will find as there is nothing to know, knowledge cannot be gained. The only thing we can do is we can drop the ignorance. And so knowing becomes a process of getting rid of ignorance. This path of knowledge is a negative path. You will get nothing in the end. That is what I said in the previous episode on the introduction to Path of Knowledge. Probably now you understand why I said that. The knowledge that we call knowledge is very, very limited. It is mostly knowledge of the illusion, since everything is dependent. Everything is illusion. All the knowledge is illusory. And it depends on this device called the mind, which I called the instrument, the only instrument that you have. And because it is a limited thing, it has its own peculiarities and it is almost never pure. There are biases, there are programs, there is a lot of ignorance that is never seen actually. It is imperfect. It will remain imperfect. It is very limited. The mind can know things that are limited by its own abilities. Even the most perfect and purified mind is limited. And so whatever can be gained, whatever can be known, is also limited. However, there is no limit to ignorance. You can go infinitely deep into the ignorance. That is unfortunate. It's because of this limit of the mind, whatever satisfies the mind is taken as knowledge. very arbitrarily. At one point, we stop seeking and we say that, okay, this much is enough for me. I know everything now. That is taken as knowledge. Now my knowledge is complete. But we will never know. Sometimes ignorance is simply this satisfaction. Oh, is it like this? Okay, I accept it. I'm satisfied with these answers. But you can see that a lot of ignorance can remain even after this attitude. The mind is limited, but it is changing, it is evolving, its abilities are increasing and so on. So we do not drop this idea of improving the instrument of the mind. As the mind evolves, the ignorance gets refined even more. The traces of ignorance may remain, but then because we are satisfied, we don't really care about it. Once you reach the essential nature of everything, then the mind should stop there because it finds nothing else. And actually, there is nothing else. What can be there once you reach the most essential? And strangely, the most essential is devoid of any knowledge. There are no concepts there. There are no ideas there. There is nothing to see there. It is complete emptiness. Just looking. Just experiencing itself. You know there is nothing to know in the illusion except the illusion. You know there is nothing to know in the truth except the emptiness. There the seeking stops. There the mind stops. And if you think that I know something now, it will be ignorance. The end of the ignorance is also the end of the knowledge. When you try to know this existence as it is, without the covering of the illusion, without the covering of the concepts, ideas, beliefs, imagination, then you will find that the mind cannot know it. And it falls in the category of the unknowable. The most basic thing is unknowable. As soon as this is understood, the mind stops struggling also. It simply accepts that I can know only this much. I can drop my ignorance only up to this point. And the struggle is over. Because unknowable means that there is no way to know anything. Anything more than this. Now we enter the mysterious. It is a very mysterious place. Where we know everything there is to know. Where we have dropped all possible visible ignorance. And still we are faced with this vast, infinite, unknowable, the existence, which is also all the experience that appears here, and it is also that which is experiencing. It is everything, obviously, so it will be the vast. It is infinite. There is nothing bigger than this. And this paradoxical superposition of knowing and not knowing at the same time is mysticism. I know, but it is mysterious. Or I know that I do not really know. This is agnosticism. Those who say that I know everything, they are deluded, obviously. Nothing can surpass the position of the agnostic. He has reached the limits, not only the limits of knowledge, he has reached the limits of the unknowable. He has touched the unknowable. Nothing can go beyond this now. No amount of knowledge will take you beyond the unknowable. All your knowledge is founded on ignorance, on this belief that something can be known. And here, we can challenge this belief. Now, I know this can be very, very confusing. So, take a few days to think about this. Once you realize all this, once you realize the true nature, once you realize what is knowledge, what is ignorance, what is illusion, once you get a fundamental understanding of these things, you will touch the unknowable. And then the struggle will be dropped and you are going to enter a peaceful state of mind, which is that of an agnostic. He knows everything but denies any knowledge because all that was known caused destruction of beliefs. Now, there is nothing left there which can be called knowledge. Knowledge was negative. The agnostic knows all the concepts in the world. All the ideas under the sun are well studied by an agnostic. He understands all philosophies completely, but drops all them. He remains free of all these things because it is an accumulation. If you ask an agnostic which philosophy you favor, what is your path, and so on, he will say none. I am free. I do not take sides. He is free from all kinds of philosophies, ideologies, traditions, belief systems, dualism, non-dualism, this-ism, that-ism. He kicks everything out. Because nothing explains the unknowable. By definition, nothing can explain it. Is there any benefit in taking a side, this side or that side, or committing to any philosophy. It is just bondage. Because my essential nature is freedom, I cannot be bound to knowledge also. When you know something, well, you know only that thing. The unknowing brings ultimate freedom. You can spot this kind of person, that he is very free. He is very light-hearted, does not take any philosophy, belief system, ideology seriously, does not go and kill people because they don't believe me. He is not trying to force any belief on anybody, even if it is truth, even if it is very sophisticated knowledge or looks like knowledge. An agnostic is not going to force it. And he can even say that I myself don't believe these things. I'm just discussing them since you are interested. He never argues. Even if there is a blatant lie in front of him, he simply smiles. There is no point. Even after argument is over, nothing will be known. Anyhow, those who are arguing, they are not interested in knowing. They are interested in winning. So agnostic person says, okay, you win. Now be happy, go home. Indulge in your ignorance. I don't care. And the way of talking of an agnostic person is asking questions, not telling answers. This is very interesting. As soon as an agnostic person asks a question, you will find that a ton of your ignorance has dropped like bricks. Total devastation has happened in your mind because of this one question that your master or this agnostic person has asked. So if he is kind enough, he will ask you something. He will ask you to look at your own beliefs and assumptions and delusions, imaginary scenarios that you cooked up in your mind or you gathered from here and there, accumulated. He will ask exactly the kind of question that will bring this house of cards down. And he prefers to show if he wants to. Otherwise, he is not interested. And he never preaches. Oh, you are ignorant, now do this and do that and fix yourself. Look, this is knowledge. Whatever I am telling you is knowledge. Whatever I am telling you is truth. But better take it. I am doing you a favor. This is not the attitude of an agnostic person. If requested, he will show you why he thinks something is like this. Something is true or something is false. He will try to show it, demonstrate it to you, provide an evidence to you. And if he cannot, he simply says, I don't know. That is the trademark of the agnostic person. I don't know. Don't ask me. He is very careless. Not interested in teaching anything. Not interested in showing anything. If he does, he does it as a play. Anyhow, the agnostic person does not really care if somebody knows anything or not. But you can see a peace on his face. You can see a brightness in his eyes. He is highly aware. He knows what is going on all the time. And he is extremely wise. Even the wisest cannot comprehend how wise he is. His wisdom sometimes looks like madness to ordinary people. Those who approach agnosticism, they can understand another agnostic. So it looks like I am trying to sell this idea of agnosticism. But I am telling you my own opinion. You are most free to adopt anything you want. You see, now I am talking like an agnostic. So I found this very, very attractive. If given the choices, would you like to have this ism, that ism, or the bigger ism which is superior and true? I'll simply say, I don't want anything. I don't know. And that is all I needed to know. So the path of knowledge may turn you into an agnostic. It will not be a surprising result. Nothing can be beyond that. If you go all the way on this path, all you are going to find is the great unknown. Not only it is unknown, it is unknowable.